Hello children, how are you all? Hope you are fine and good. I am your teacher Dakshayini, handling biology from Bharathasanar Metric Higher Secondary School, Arakkonam. Children, today we are going to see 11th standard zoology chapter 4, organ and organ system in animals. What are all the things we are discussing in this chapter, children? We are studying the various systems in earthworm, cockroach and the frog. Let us go into the session. In the previous session, we discussed about the earthworm. Especially in the last session, we discussed earthworms. That is, what is the scientific name of earthworm? Yes, very good. So, Lampitomorti. And later we discussed about the reproductive system, excretory system, life cycle, and what are all the economic importance of the earthworm. What are all the economic importance we discussed? It is the growth of earthworms, we call it as vermiculture. It is helpful in making the vermicompost, which is nowadays very useful in the persons who are interested in organic farming. So in this session, we are going to see about a cockroach. Right? So, can you say some things about the cockroach, children? See, we everyone are allergic towards a cockroach. Yes? And sometimes a persons with asthma, right? Their symptoms may be aggravated due to the smell produced by the cockroach. And this cockroach, it is an insect. It belongs to a class Insecta and phylum Arthropoda. And it is a cosmopolitan. Just underline a word in your book, children. Cosmopolitan. What do you mean by cosmopolitan? It is found in all habitats. For example, you can see in your home, you can see the cockroaches sometimes in the kitchen, right? Near the wash basins and in the storerooms. Sometimes it is found in the restaurants and it is also in the hotels, bakeries. So, hence it is found everywhere. It is said to be cosmopolitan. And the cockroach is nocturnal. What do you mean by nocturnal? Just underline and write. Active during the night time. Yes, you can see on the daytime you cannot see the cockroaches anywhere, but at the night time you can see the cockroaches moving here and there, right? And the cockroach is cursorial. What do you mean by cursorial? Underline and write, children. The legs of the insect which is modified for walking or running, we say it as cursorial. So now let us see some of the important characteristic features of this cockroach. So first, it's a 2-mark question. Write the classification of cockroach. So cockroach belongs to the phylum Arthropoda. It belongs to the phylum Arthropoda. Arthros means jointed. Poda means feet. We discussed this in the Kingdom Animalia lesson. Since they have the jointed feet, they are said to, they belong to the phylum Arthropoda. Class Insecta. Class Insecta. And this phylum Arthropoda, it is a largest phylum of Kingdom Animalia. Order. Orthoptera. What do you mean by Orthoptera? Ortho means straight and pteros means wings. The cockroach possesses the straight wings, hence it belongs to the order Orthoptera. And genus, the genus name is Periplaneta. Periplaneta. And the species name is Americana. So what is the binomial name of cockroach? Periplaneta Americana. So this is the classification of cockroach, children. It is an important 2-mark question. Just go through it. So next we are going to see some of the important characteristic features of the cockroach, right? The cockroach, the body is dorsoventrally flattened. What do you mean by dorsoventrally, children? It is flattened both by the upper and lower. You can see the cockroach is very flat, right? And the length of the adult cockroach, the length is 2 to 4 centimeter and the width is 1 centimeter. And the cockroach is bilaterally symmetrical. What do you mean by bilateral symmetry, children? We discussed in the second lesson. If an organism is divisible into two equal parts from only one plane, we say the organism is bilaterally symmetrical. And the body of the cockroach is divisible into head. This portion is referred as a head, thorax, and the abdomen. Again, the thorax is divisible into three, that is prothorax, prothorax, mesothorax, and metathorax. So, first in this session, we are going to discuss only about the head of the cockroach, right? Here you can see the head is located at right angles to the body, and it is, the head is connected to a body by means of a short neck, so that the head is flexible. And the head of the cockroach consists of a pair of antenna, by the length of the antenna we can guess whether it is a male or a female. If the antenna is very long and if it extends beyond the abdomen of the cockroach, we say it is a male. If the antenna is short, we can say it is a female. So this antenna, it is a sense organ which is very helpful in vibration, in absorbing the vibrations. And apart from this, the head consists of eyes. The eyes of the cockroach, we can say it is large, sessile. Sessile means what? We can move our eyelids here and there, but the cockroach cannot move it, eyelids. Next, sessile, and the another one is that reniform. What do you mean by reniform? The eyes of the cockroach is kidney shaped. So, what are the two sense organs, children? We discussed about the antenna, and another one is about the eyes. So next we are going to see about the mouth. So before going to that, we shall see what are all the segments, right? You can see the body of the cockroach is divisible into 10 segments. And the exoskeleton is covered by a thick structure called as sclerites, If the sclerites is present on the dorsal, means what? Mudugu pakkam, right? If it is present on the dorsal side, it is said to be pterygoids. And if it is present on the ventral side, it is, ventral means adibagam, right? It is said to be sternites. And if it is present on the lateral sides, that is in the sides, we say it as pleurites. But all these pterygoids, sternites, and pleurites all together is called as the sclerites. So now let us see the mouth parts of cockroach. So this is a mouth. The mouth of the cockroach, we say it as hypognathus. What do you mean by hypognathus, children? Hypo means below, gnathus means mouth. We can see the mouth of the cockroach is facing downwards. The mouth is present only on the ventral side. See, this is the eyes and this is the antennae, and you can see the mouth parts lying at the ventral side of the cockroach. So we can say the mouth of the cockroach is hypognathus, and it is of biting and chewing type. It can, the cockroach can bite the food with the help of the jaws, and it can chew the food. So you can say the mouth is of mandibulate type. And the mouth parts is divisible. These are all the mouth parts, children. The first one, it's an important 3-mark question. They will ask you to draw and label the mouth parts of cockroach. The upper lip, we call it as a labrum. What is upper lip? It is called as upper lip, labrum. And the lower lip, labium. upper lip, lower lip, and a pair of maxillae and a pair of mandibles, which is used for cutting and chewing the food. Next, it consists of a tongue. The tongue is otherwise called as hypopharynx. So, what are all the parts included in the mouth parts of cockroach, children? Upper lip or labrum, lower lip or labium, a pair of maxillae, a pair of mandible, and a small tongue, that is hypopharynx. So, these are all the mouth parts of the cockroach. Let us recap what are all the things we discussed, children. First, we discussed about the classification of the cockroach. Classification of the cockroach, and later in the morphology, that is in the external structure, we discussed about the head. About the head, and later on we discussed about the what are all the general characteristics of the cockroach. And in the head, we discussed about the three important parts: eyes, antennae, and the mouth parts. With this session comes to an end, children. In the next session, we shall see about the thorax and abdomen of the cockroach. In the description, we have attached the study material, assessment, and question bank for this lesson. Go through it. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.